My dear friends, today I will be discussing about the various causes of mitral stenosis, or also known as mitral valvular stenosis. So most common cause of mitral stenosis is rheumatic fever or rheumatic heart disease. Now before that, we must know that there are several causes of mitral stenosis, and what is mitral stenosis we must know. Mitral stenosis simply means stenosis or narrowing of the orifice of the mitral valve of the heart. Mitral valve is a valve which is present on the atrioventricular orifice of the left heart, or left atrioventricular orifice. Between the left atrium and left ventricle, there is a orifice or aperture, and that is aperture is made up of mitral valve. So during the cardiac cycle or during the diastole of the heart, when heart undergoes diastolic expansion or relaxation, left this mitral valve undergoes opening, or because of opening of mitral valve, blood from the left atrium enters into the left ventricle, and that is the normal function of mitral valve. But in case of mitral stenosis, there may be narrowing or defect in the opening of the mitral valve, and that's why blood from the left atrium cannot open into the left ventricle. So there is a improper ventricular filling, which ultimately affects the cardiac output or the normal function of heart. So that is the pathophysiological finding of mitral stenosis. And as the disease becomes severe, there is a gradual increase in left atrial pressure, and which is transmitted to the pulmonary veins through brake pressure, and finally it increases the pulmonary arterial blood pressure, or also leads to pulmonary hypertension. This pulmonary hypertension may creates or increase the capillary hydrostatic pressure of the pulmonary capillaries, and because of that there is a formation of edema in the lung, leading also known as pulmonary edema. Besides, because of persistent pulmonary hypertension, it leads to right ventricular hypertrophy, which eventually leads to right ventricular failure. Besides, with the gradual increase in the left atrial pressure, there is a increase risk of gradual increase in the left atrial size, and that's why left atrium become gradually increase in size, which ultimately weakens the wall of the left atrium, which leads to atrial fibrillation. Because of atrial fibrillation, there is a increased risk of thromboembolism or increased blood clot formation in the left atrium, which ultimately lodge into the systemic circulation and ultimately transferred to the systemic circulation, leading to cerebrovascular accident or even stroke. So what I mean to say is that mitral stenosis can even lead to complication like stroke also. So that is the rough concept of or pathophysiology of mitral stenosis. Now we'll discuss about the causes or what are the etiology of mitral stenosis. Now, most common cause or reason behind the mitral stenosis is the rheumatic heart disease or rheumatic fever. So streptococcus infection, especially post-streptococcus infection, may lead to valvular involvement or valvular infection, which ultimately leads to stenosis of the mitral valve, and that's why mitral stenosis can occur as a complication of rheumatic heart disease or rheumatic fever. So most common cause of mitral stenosis is rheumatic heart disease or rheumatic fever. Besides, there is some uncommon cause like mitral calcification. So mitral calcification or calcium deposition in mitral valve also leads to mitral stenosis, but it is not common, so it is one of the uncommon cause of mitral stenosis. Besides, some congenital heart disease may be associated with mitral stenosis. Example is Luttenbacher syndrome. In Luttenbacher syndrome, there may be ASD along with mitral stenosis. So some congenital heart disease may be associated with mitral stenosis. Besides, infective endocarditis. What is endocarditis? Endocarditis means inflammation of inner lining of the heart. That is endocardium. So infective endocarditis also leads to mitral stenosis. Besides, there are some rare causes like mitral annular calcification. So that may be leads to or that may be a rare cause of mitral stenosis. Besides, some other causes are there, like endomyocardial fibroelastosis, that is the mineralization of the elastic fibers or fibers of the present in the heart. So endomyocardial fibroelastosis, that may be another rare condition. Besides, some cancerous condition like malignant carcinoid syndrome may also leads to mitral stenosis. Besides, there may be SLE, systemic lupus erythematosus, that can also leads to mitral stenosis. Besides, some disease like Fabry's disease, then Hunter's disease, then Hurler's disease, amyloidosis also leads to mitral stenosis. Last but not the least, even rheumatoid arthritis is a autoimmune disease, can also leads to mitral stenosis. So these are the very rare condition or rare causes or etiology of mitral stenosis, but most common cause is rheumatic heart disease or rheumatic fever. Besides infective endocarditis, then congenital heart disease and mitral calcification can be some of the uncommon causes, but most common cause is rheumatic heart disease or rheumatic fever. So these are the various causes of mitral stenosis. Thank you very much.